Here we go. Take out your assignments. We got to get going here. Too much to do and too little time to do it.
I can't hear you. What?
I had sleep night with my family, so I got back a little late, so I didn't get to do it.
And you have a note? Here we go.
Kids, Joey has an announcement. Joey, can you stand up with your announcement? Because I cannot wait.
Yes, sir. Louder, Joey. Well, Joey, if you can't find it, who would you like to ask to help you look for it? Kelsey, do you want to help Joey look for his assignment? Where, if you had suggestions, Kelsey, where should Joey look for his assignment? Quite possibly where? Wait, here's my, this is my, ooh, go check your locker. Wait, let's see if this works. This would be crazy. What I'm saying is this is where this gets crazy. Watch. I can.
This, ladies and gentlemen, would be something. I'm not sure how this would work. Hold on a second. Maybe.
I do have a YouTube channel.
I used to have my own website, but take a look at this. Wait. Watch. Okay.
Oh, that does not. That
science.
Is.
I mean, technology.
What just happened there? Why is this not? Oh. Oh. Where'd it go? Hold on a second. I think if I get this just right, we don't have this much time to play. Oh. Am I stuck in some sort of an infinite window or what? You can see my thing. What's it show?
I think, wait a second.
We've got multiple outlets and multiple things going on here, Lizzie. I don't know what's going to happen. The suspense is killing me a little bit last.
Yay!
Now, watch, look, learn, and listen. Zach. How about that, huh? You just don't get that kind of entertainment, Zach, anywhere.
Here we go, let's correct. Was this 11A?
Yes. I can't be right about most things, but I'm right about 11A.
One should be 1,600 feet cubed.
Right now, you don't have any assignment at all. You don't have a paper. You don't have anything. So what do you plan on doing this whole time? Nothing? I guess. Did Joey find his?
Number two. Zach is?
40 questions.
40 questions. Three. Make it the deal. 900. Four. Harper. 41 yards. Five has these points. 6, 6. -3, 6. -3. -3. And 6, -3. Number six, Kelsey.
X equals 40 degrees. Kelsey, I can tell you're going to ask me a question at number five, aren't you?
Seven, Carrie Dixon.
7 should be 70,000. 7 is 70,000. Number 8, Hadley Hopkins. Point, how many zeros? 4 zeros, 8. Point 4 zeros, 8. Number 9, children. See, I can actually do this now. Looking over there, is that going to be too distracting? Some of you will not be able to focus, I'm sure, if I keep this going like this. Number 9, for the function y equals negative 2, you have a d, and it goes like this. Yep, yep. Number 10, Owen.
5, 6.
5, 6. 11, Finn. 21. 12, Kate. 1.4. 13, Michael. 1.6 times 10 to the third power. 14, Lizzie Himes. 1.2 times 10 to the 8th. Said with great confidence. Sophia, how about number 15? Just 8x squared. I don't have a Y. Why, I don't know. Gavin, 16. 4.5. 17, Clay Johnson.
6x squared plus
4x. 6x squared minus 4x. 6x squared minus 4x. Chase, 18. 5x minus 2y. By the way, some very nice pictures, boys, on Facebook. Very nice. Those pictures taken yesterday. Number 19, everybody says is?
C.
C. And number 20, 314 inches squared. 314 inches squared. These, ladies and gentlemen, are the times that will try men's souls. Mostly mine. Yours, I don't know. Molly.
What was 17?
What were or what was? 6x squared minus 4x. Meg. Let's do the answers first and then I'll do it. Suze. Answers first, Suze. Suze, which one you got? Anytime you're ready.
12 and
11. 12 is 1.4. 11 is 21. Hadley? 14 was 1.2 times 10 to the 8th. Cora. 13 was 1.6 times 10 to the 3rd. Michael. 15 is 8x squared. All right, here comes the part of the show that I oh so look forward each and every time. Remember, you must preface your question with, how do you do? And I will respond with, very well, how do you do? And then you ask me the question. Now, Riley. Oh.
How do you do?
I do very well. How do you do? What's your question?
Number 5.
How do we do number 5? And again, ladies and gentlemen, again, you can have a piece of paper, if so desired, for notes. You don't have to, certainly. You're not forced to in any way, but you can use those. This, ladies and gents, is the way that yours will look much better than I, simply because I don't know if I have. Hold on a second. I might be able to get us a piece. Hold on just a second. Let's see. I might be able to do this for us. I love technology. Let me cut this bad boy out, put him on our paper. Anybody know where we're at? I am getting lost. How many different technological advances can we have here? So here, I'm going to put this thing paste. So the first thing, ladies and gents, you would do on this is you would graph that square, and then you're supposed to dilate it. I would graph it first. You probably think you could do it without, I don't know. So the square is negative 1, 2. Negative 1, 2.
1, -1, -1, -2, and 2, -1. So here's your square, right? Did you start with that? Say yes, please.
Yeah.
And then dilation means, dilation is multiplied by, it's a factor, it grows bigger. And it says it grows dilated from the origin, which I believe is just what it is with a scale factor of 3. So you're just multiplying every point times 3. So -1, -2 would end up being -3, -6. Oh, we don't have to draw it. Did it ask us? No, it just asked for the coordinates. We don't even have to draw this. Sorry, kids. You just multiply everything by 3. You get -3, -6, -3, -3, 6, 6, and 6, -3. Was that the answers? I think it was. Yeah. Just note to self, just multiply everything by 3. That's what a scale factor is, times 3. Michael! Let's do 15. Yes, let's do 15. Anybody want to speculate what Mr. Hahn's first words are? Susie.
Combine like terms?
No. Combining like terms only happens when there's pluses and minuses. Okay. There are that this has simply one term. It's all one big thing. Okay. So first thing is this. Anything to the zero exponent is
1.
And 1 times anything is whatever's there. This, anything to the, I had the same exact discussion with 8th grade today. This goes away. There's nothing there because it's a 1. And 1 times anything is itself, so you just left with that. So now, I hope I have this. I can't really see it. X to the -1 over X to the 3. What do I do, Clay Johnson, next? I don't care which screen you look at because they're both the same. All right, 2 things you can think about here, kids. This is whatever way works good for you. You go over here, not over there. You're not funny. I can stand in front of this and you can't see me there. Actually, that might be better over there. Now, you probably could stop reading amidst of all this and actually follow along. Why would you not write notes to yourself on this? Do you not think that would be beneficial? Just me? These are the same bases to exponents. What do you do when you have same bases and you multiply them together? You add the exponents. What do you get if you add these two together? What's a -1 and 3? 2. So this is 2 to the 3rd power, which is 2 times 2 times 2. 8. And you put those together, it's x squared. Now, if that doesn't float your boat, somebody said this, and this is perfectly okay too. Sorry. You can move this to the bottom and make it positive. It just becomes a positive x. But look what happens. It crosses off with one of the 3 x's on top, and you're still left with x squared on top. And you still have 2 to the 3rd power 8 x squared there. Yabo? Susie! Oh. I do fine. How are you doing today?
Good. Can you do number 1?
I can do number 1. I'll bet I did number 1 some in a previous life somewhere. Number 1 says a contractor rents a storage room for tools. The room is 20 feet long by 10 feet wide by 8 feet high. Did you happen to draw that out, Susie? All right. 20 feet long by 10 feet wide by 8 feet high. Ladies and gentlemen, can anybody tell me another word for the word capacity? Help me out here. Volume. You are simply, and again, this should be an easy thing for you to get right tomorrow because you are just finding the volume. How much stuff will fit into it? Volume is length times width times height. You're allowed to use that volume formula for a rectangular prism, and you don't have to use the area of the base times the height, which is other ones. It's just going to be 20 times 10 times 8, 200 times 8, 1,600 feet cubed. I wouldn't think there'd be a reason why anyone would get that wrong tomorrow. I can't imagine it getting any easier than that. Finn Hood?
Oh, how do you do? I'm sorry. I'm doing well, thank you. How do you do? Number 17. Ladies and gentlemen, I will tell you, if one of the Hood brothers asks a question, I'm going to guess that most of you want to pay attention, because when it comes to mathematics, they're pretty sharp. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Susie, this is for you. Guess what? How many terms do I have there? Four, separated by adding subtracting sign. What makes something a like term? You can combine, put together, collect, as the book says, like terms. What has to be true for them to put them together? Again, I used to say this. Think about X's are like seventh graders and X squareds. Like eighth graders think they're so much better than you because they're squared. Okay, they don't get along with each other. You don't put them together. They don't mix. They're going to go with the people of their own like. So X squareds don't go with X's. Okay. If I have five eighth graders and I put another eighth grader with them, what do I have? Six eighth graders. They don't turn into high school seniors by becoming X to the fourth. You don't do anything with their exponents. That's when you multiply, exponents change. When you add and collect, they stay the same. Now, three seventh graders left and then another seventh grader left. What has happened? Four seventh graders have left. They've gone away. They're gone. Boom. It's only when you multiply two negatives, you get a positive. When you add two negatives, you get a bigger negative. Where did you go wrong on that there, Finn?
My answer ended up being 22x.
Whole Cheeman City.
Because someone told me 5x squared was 25x.
Would that be your brother? Because I don't think...
No, I don't remember.
Finn, if I were you, I don't know. If you didn't understand it, I don't know how many people in this class I'd do this. Maybe a couple. You can. There's always people that understand some things or the other things.
I don't know.
Wow. Suddenly things are getting heated here. I can see Megan. If Megan doesn't know something, she is the first one to admit she doesn't know. There's nothing wrong with not knowing. Megan, what do you got? Maybe you can throw a pin under the bus on this next one. Oh, I do fine. How are you doing? Number 14. Is it up or top? Down or below? Is it down here? Is it on top? Am I going to do all this? Oh, ladies and gentlemen, I don't know where. I blame all the breaks we've had that you don't get this because too many people had this trouble here. I don't know where things went on. Is 13 the one that's division and this one multiplication? Yeah. Let's just look at both of these together. This is multiplication. This is division. Why? Fractions are nothing more than glorified division problems. For this one, you multiply, you multiply the left things together. For this one, you divide the left things together. 4 times 3 is 12. You write down your times 10. 4.8 divided by 3, let's just go with it. It's 1.6 times 10. For multiplying, you add the exponents together. I don't know what those exponents are because blown up it looks really, is it 10? Oh, this is a what? That's a 4. That's a 3. So you get 7. This one you subtract exponents, which is, what are those exponents? 5 and 3? What is that on your paper? 8 and 5? This one, make sure you're subtracting the bound from top, so this is 10 to the third. Now, one of those is okay, one of them's not. This one you can leave because it is between 1 and 10, so you don't have to change anything. This is your answer. This one is incorrect because it's no longer in scientific notation because you can't have a 12 in scientific notation. Here is your notes to yourself. You need to take the decimal and move it so that it does become between 1 and 10. So it becomes 1.2, but the question is, if I do that, what happens to my exponent there? Does it get one bigger or does it get one smaller? If you make this, you think opposites. If you make this one smaller, this becomes one bigger. So it should be 10 to the 8. Things looking crazy over there. God bless you. I don't know. I feel like the dual monitors might be confusing.
Kelsey!
I do fine. How are you doing?
Wait, how do you do? Sorry, you go. What's your question? Number two. Number two. Number two. Although, this is a great question. I had a couple of a lot of people ask me this one. Although six of Simon's answers were incorrect, 85% of his answers were correct. How many questions did Simon answer at all? Ladies and gentlemen, this is a percentage box problem. You got to take the things you know, plug them into the box, and see where you go. First of all, I am comparing correct answers to incorrect answers. It doesn't matter which one you put where. Let's go correct here, incorrect here. And when you put the correct with the incorrect, you're always going to get 100%. 85% answers were correct, which means what percent was incorrect? 15. If, although six were incorrect, so that is the actual number of incorrect, how many questions were there in all? So there's my equal fractions I need to make. I don't need this 85 part. I did figure out that was 15, but 15 over 100 equals 6 over something. Here's where it's kind of up to you what you want to do to solve this. First thing you look at is, can you go from 15 to 6? Not particularly. So try number two would be to do what? I would reduce this fraction and see if then I could go down to 6. You don't have to. You can do it. You can do the cross multiplication, but 5 goes into both of these, 3 over 20, same fraction. And then I would just go, 3 times 2, 20 times 2. There must have been 40 questions. You don't like that, then by all means go 15 times n equals 6 times 100 and do the division. You'll still get 40. Your call. More than one way to skin a skunk, right? That's what we came up with. Was that what it was? Was that a different class? All right, I'll talk to myself. I'm not against that. Hoopah! Where are we at here? Molly! I'm doing fine. How do you do? At one point in time, I'm pretty sure I could. I'll back them up. How about anybody? Keywords on this one? This one's going to be simplify and then combine, collect, slash, whatever like terms. But before I do that, I have to do what property, Michael?
Yeah.
You have to get rid of these parentheses by multiplying out by the two. And if you had to pick a color, what would you call that color? I don't know if it's right. I would call it pasty something. 3x, what is 2 times x? 2x. What is 2 times negative y minus 2y? Do I even have any like terms there, Sophia? What? Yeah, 2 seventh graders there. You have two seventh graders and put 2 more seventh graders with them. What do you have? Huh? 5 what? Seventh graders or eighth graders? Seventh graders, yeah, they don't become x squareds. And this one doesn't have any terms, so you just tack it on the end. Ooh. We are 20 after 5 already. Gavin, you raise your hand last. I can't call on you because I know people would think that I pick you over top of everybody else. Riley. I'm doing fine. How do you do? What is it? Which one? 20, ladies and gents. 20s. The diameter of a cylindrical barrel was 20 inches. I assume you drew that cylindrical barrel?
Yeah.
So here's my cylindrical barrel. This diameter was 20 inches. Was lit when the barrel was lifted away, the imprint on the circle, what was the area of the circle? So if this barrel was sitting on the ground, somebody pulled it off,
You're going to get an imprint of a circle. Look, I'll make it three-dimensional. Maybe that'll help. Look at that. That's pretty. It still has a 20-inch diameter. Riley, tell me you wrote down the formula for the area of a circle, which is? No, that's the circumference of a circle. And there's where you can note for self, if you got 20 wrong, it's probably because you wrote the wrong formula. Area is 20 times pi r squared, or 20 times pi r. What is the radius of that thing, Kate? You probably don't have to look at your paper. If it has a diameter of 20, the radius is 10, which should make you smile, because one of the only times I say you really don't have to show me your work is right there, because 10 times 10 is 100, Joey. And 3.14 times 100, Joey, is 3.14 times 100, mental math right there is 300,000, no, two zeros, Joey. Move the decimal two places to the right. It's just 314, whatever it is, inches squared. Did we not do this before? I thought we did this before. All right, look me on that. Carrie, have we heard from you today?
I'm sorry.
I'm doing fine. How are you doing? I can do six. Have you ever heard the song Kathmandu? Gavin, that would be you. You seem to be an old-time rock and roll kind of guy. I'm going to Kathmandu. What? Bob Seger? If we have enough time, Gav, I'll fire it up for you. What is the measure of angle X? Chase, we'll leave this in your hands. How in the wide, wide world of sports am I going to find how big angle X is? Am I going to use if two parallel lines are cut by a transversal? No, because there are two parallel lines there. So that's out. What do I need to know? Fact number one, I need to know that. Okay, top is, this is 90 degrees. So far, so good. I agree. I know that because there's a square corner put there. And then is 50. Why is it 50? Who knows the big long word that we learned? Somebody tell me the big long word that two angles added together give you a straight line. What's the name of that? Harper? I thought you raised your hand. That's what. Michael? Yeah. Two supplementary angles, if they form a straight line, they have to add up to 180 degrees. And Chase says, boom, that has to be 50 degrees. That still doesn't tell me what X is. Then you need to know angles have 180 degrees. How do I know that? Where's 180 come from? Yeah, all triangles, no matter what they are, have to add up to 180 degrees. So 90 plus 50 plus what is 180 degrees? Or another way to think about it is, you know this is 90, so you got to have 90 more degrees. 50 plus what number gives you 90 degrees? Again, should not be above 7th grade math, 40 degrees. They do something wrong, because when people raise their hand like that, so I really think that I did something wrong. Because they're usually pretty anxious to correct the teacher. And I do stuff wrong all the time. Soph! I'm sorry?
How are you?
I'm doing fine. How do you do? Number nine. Wait, have we done number nine? You did that just because I put something in front of number nine, didn't you? Did you not? I'm going to put this in El Garbajo can. Oh, wait, I need that back. Can I undo that? Sure, I can. Why can't I get to, I'm going to make this small.
Here is number 9, basically in a nutshell, because I don't think, wait, have we graphed linear equations in slope-intercept form? We have, haven't we? Oh, Sophia, what's going on here? I just want to graph this equation, y equals x minus 2. First thing I do is what, why, where, when, and how. It's called slope-intercept form. Gavin, I put, you could. But there's an easier way to do it. Did we do slope-intercept form? Okay, let's go with that because that's simple. Let's do Gavin's thing first. Gavin says, well, you could certainly just make a table. I get to pick what I want for x. Let's say I pick negative 2, 0, and positive 2. Positive 2 minus 2 is 0. 0 minus 2 is negative 2. Negative 2 minus 2 is negative 4. You could do that, but there's an easier way, and then plot those points and draw the line. Joey, what's your thoughts? I should turn the TV off, is what I'm thinking. That's my thought. Somebody help me out on this. Slope intercept. Clay Johnson? What do I do first in slope intercept? It's called slope intercept. Slope intercept. Or slope, actually. Slope here, intercept there. Well, for you. Slope is here, intercept is there. So I do what? Let's move on with this, please. Somebody help me. Chase, somebody, either one of you, give me something. I graph where the y-intercept, which is what? Yeah. Whatever this number is, boys and girls, that's where it crosses the y-axis. Look, boom, that's the y-intercept. Now, the part that I'm missing in slope-intercept now is the slope. What number is the slope that you can't see because we don't put it in front of letters when there is this? Susie?
One.
A 1. The slope is whatever fraction is in front of the x. Well, there is no fraction in front of the x, which means it's 1. And what fraction makes 1? 1 over 1. And that's what I do. It's positive slope, so I go up 1 over 1, up 1 over 1. Up 1 over 1, up 1 over 1, up 1 over 1. It doesn't matter how many times, but that's the line. Which will be the exact same thing. If you put 0, negative 2, it's there. 2 comma 0 is there. Negative 2, negative 4. Ooh. Quickly, what time is it? Oh, 5 more minutes, is it? Kelsey? I'm doing fine. How are you doing? Number 12. Is that on this page? Tell me it's over here. It's up here. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, equations. What type of equation is this? This is both an addition equation and a multiplication equation. How do I solve equations? I do the opposite. Which one do I do first? What's the opposite of this? What's the opposite of that? Which one goes first? Kelsey, do I divide by 3 or do I subtract 1.8? No. Order of operations is reversed when you solve an equation because you're working from the answer backwards, kind of. So the first thing you have to do is subtract 1.8. Get rid of that. Subtract 1.8 from 6, I get 4.2. We're just going to kind of do this fast. Then what's left? 3 times x is 4.2, so you, opposite of multiplying is divide. 4.2 divided by 3 is 1.4. Take my word for it. Other questions? Clay? Oh, I do fine. How are you doing? God bless you.
Can you do 3?
I'm kind of like speed dating now. The machine can produce 120 plastic dinosaurs in 8 minutes. So this is, ladies and gentlemen, simply nothing more than a ratio. You are comparing how much it can make, the plastic pieces, in how many minutes. Here's your ratio. You are doing 120 of these in 8 minutes. They want to know how many you can do in an hour, 60 minutes. So there is your whole thing. It'd be nice if we could go from 8 to 60, but we can't. So again, just like before, your first thought is, can I reduce this to something that will work? I'm sorry, this is 60. What can you divide 128 by? 4. If I cut them both by 4, actually, okay, you get 30 over 2.
2 times what is 60? 30, and 30 times 30 is 900. Who? Susie! I'm sorry, what?
How do you do?
I'm doing fine, how are you doing?
Right, I know
you can't forget the rules of the game, even though it's late, yes.
For number 2, I was confused because I put, I know we already did it, but I already, like, I flipped up, like, if I put that on the right, and I didn't know if that would matter or not.
You put all of this on this side?
Mm-hmm.
Don't matter.
Alright.
As long as you're putting percentages on one column and everything else in the other column. Hopkins! I'm sorry, what? Yeah, what? Which one? Number 10. Because I don't know how much time I got left, and it is Spanish, so I can't go too much over. 10. Is it a different page here? 10. 10. You have contains 10 red. I'm just going to put 10 R, 20 white, 30 blue. If one marble is drawn from the bag, what's the probability the marble is not red? How many total marbles is 10, 20, and 30? 60. How many of those 60 are not red? Yeah, and that's your probability. You just need to reduce it 5/6. Yeah? Is that yours, Gavin? Was that the answer? Is that your question? I know you had one. What's your question? Quick. I'm sorry, what? How do you do? 11? Last one before we go. Oh, Gav. Same thing I just talked about here. You cannot go from 20 to 35, so can you reduce this fraction to something that you could? What number goes into 12 and 20? 4. Divide by 4, you get 3. Divide by 4, you get 5. 5 times what is 35? 7. 3 times 7 is 21. All right. If you have other questions, you have to catch them and turn around. Let me get to your festival. Those of you that are leaving early, you will take it. This festival stone has one small one you can take before you go. So bring it up before you go, though. You know, that one was going on. Make sure you get test note before you go, Laura. Don't leave me lying so long. Make sure you got test note before you go, go.
Back in the room.
Get back. Get back.
So
I didn't hear from the question. I'm going to go back inside. I'm going to go back. No, that's what I'm going to do. You must hurry.
Hurry. Can we leave back? You jump.
Good.